and the dill in there. Oh, that's what makes it. That's like what brings it to the next level.
Moving through the meats, next up for the kebab.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's meat umami. Taste the smokiness of it, how it's been. And the saltiness as well, how it's just been scorched over the hot coals.
Got it. Kitty.
It was all good, but that horse noodle like dough dish with the soup, and that is unique and just it's incredibly good. It's oh man, it's good. We're gonna go back to the hotel. We're gonna rest for a couple hours, and then we have one more meal to complete this first my very first day in Uzbekistan. It's been nothing short of just impressive. And met so many friendly people, so much good food, but we all have to say we have one more big dinner coming up.
Charlie, kitty. Come on, Charlie.
Okay, we went back to the hotel. We rested for about an hour. It's a very modern, but very nice, very beautiful restaurant with modern Uzbekistan style. And we're eating a dish. It's called shpildok. Look at this platter. It's a beauty. It's another stunner. And if you can notice right in the center, you will see the horse sausage that we've already eaten once or twice or three times.
This guy is nothing but being chasing Charlie. He doesn't leave him alone.
Sausage, that's like one of the winning meats of the day. It's like sheets of what look like kind of like dough. Okay, and I got some horse meat on there as well, of course. Well, that's incredible. Those are like noodle sheets. You've got that really meaty broth that the noodles have sort of soaked up with. That horse meat, which is salty and like horse salami, and then the crispness of the green onions.
What do you think? What is the main ingredient? What is the main ingredient?
The noodle or the dough?
No. No? And it's not even the meat.
No, it's the meat. The broth. So yeah, every now and then, like in this, like you get a cumin seed.
Yeah.
It's a whole cumin seed, but it's kind of mild.
Get the day away.
The food, the culture. We landed about, less than 24 hours in Tashkent. Slept for like 2.5-3 hours. Then immediately got started on this Tashkent food tour. Truly a learning and just a beautiful, beautiful day. I loved the food. I loved the different dishes I've never seen or even imagined before. But even more than the food, the people, the hospitality, the friendliness and genuine kindness. So many people that we met today.
That really
stands out. So I want to say a huge thank you to the Ministry of Tourism of Uzbekistan who invited Ying and I to Uzbekistan. Thank you so much for making this happen. Thank you to Bekruz. Bekruz arranged everything. He did a lot of work to make this happen. So thank you so much. And to Akbar. And also to Rashvan for coming along with us today. Man, what an amazing day we have.
It's just
one of Uzbekistan. We have so much more food, adventures, and experiences in Uzbekistan that I'm going to share with you in this entire series. So stay tuned. And yeah, be sure to watch this entire series. I'm going to say good night.
Quítate, güey.
And I will see you on the next video. Thanks so much for watching. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you're not already subscribed, click subscribe now. And also click that little bell icon so that you get notified of the next video that I publish. Thanks again for watching. See you on the next video.
Good.
Everyone, hope you're having an amazing day. It's Mark Weens. I'm so excited to be in Lima, Peru. Peruvian food is one of the best food cultures in the entire world. Today we are going to go on an ultimate street food tour of Lima. We're going to visit markets. We're going to go to street food carts. We're going to eat some of the best Peruvian food in one single day in Lima. I'm going to meet up with my friend Timor, and I'm going to share all the food with you and this entire
good.
And the amazing
Peruvian
food with you. Now.
Timur, how are you, man?
Great, great.
And Timur, you're originally from France. How did you stay